Good morning, everybody. 6:42 as we start this forecast with a beautiful, vibrant, colorful shot. I think this is a sunrise, and the reason I say that is because this comes in from Tyler over on the other side of the state off Instagram, Harbor Beach, Michigan. That's on Lake Huron. Typically, you get the good sunrises there, but depending upon where he was, I suppose it's possible if he was on the opposite side of the lake, maybe that was a maybe that's a sunset, but I'm thinking sunrise here. But love the colors in that. I put that on Facebook. If you want to connect with me on Facebook, it's Kevin Craig Fox 17. Twitter or Instagram or your thing, it's at Fox Weatherman. That's the handle. And as we look at our surface map, we've got a low pressure system off to our north and west, and there's a front draped over the area. And we are between these two fronts. This is actually going to become a warm front as it lifts to the north. And we're between that and this cold front. And our next weather maker is really right here. It's a low that's going to move in our way. And as it does, it'll take a few days to get here, but that'll likely produce some widespread showers, maybe a rumble of thunder, especially as we get into Thursday. But we're in this warm flow, what we call the warm sector of this system, and we are out ahead of it, and that means a strong southwest wind here over the next few days, which will drive our temperatures well into the 70s. I wouldn't even rule out the possibility of an 80-degree temperature. It'd be our first one this year, especially from Grand Rapids down to the south, especially tomorrow. You can see there's not much going on live Doppler radar until we pull out to a wider perspective. Remember our conversation yesterday at this time? We had a pretty good cluster of some showers and storms moving into our area right now. There's a lot of gray shading on the map. That's some high and mid-level clouds coming in off these showers and thunderstorms off to our north and west around Green Bay. These are moving more easterly. They're not really dropping down to the south, so we are expecting to stay dry. Some of this line could possibly fill in and move our way, so the chance of a shower, a thunder shower, will be there as we go through the day today, but it's not real impressive on radar and the forecast models. The short-term models we look at take this system to the east, affecting and impacting more northern lower Michigan than our area today. Take a look at our temperatures. Very much on the mild side. That's one of the biggest things you're going to notice as you head out this morning. There's a pretty good change, though, between the far eastern portion of our viewing area. Marshall is 49 degrees. It's 45 in Coldwater, but you go far enough to the west. Lawton is 60 degrees. It's 62 right now in South Haven, 51 in Hastings, 52 in Hopkins. We have 53 in Grand Rapids, 52 in Sparta, 48 in Cedar Springs, and even our northern counties. Look at the difference here. 46 in Big Rapids, but Fremont is 55 degrees. So that's one of the biggest things you're going to notice on this Tuesday morning is it's fairly mild out there. So we don't have to go far to climb to a reasonable level here. I think we'll hit temperatures in the mid, the upper 70s today. And some of that milky white sunshine will occur. So we'll call it partly cloudy at times, partly sunny skies. Those are unseasonably warm temperatures, folks, considering our normal high for this time of the year is 54 degrees. We'll have a south to southwest wind at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Watch what happens on the forecast model as we go through the day. Not much, just partly cloudy to partly sunny skies, mainly dry conditions here. This is today at 6 p.m. and then as we go through the overnight hours, we've got just partly cloudy skies here. We go through our Wednesday, we might start to see some moisture get flung up here as we get into Wednesday afternoon. A chance of a shower or thunderstorm at that time, but we're still out ahead of this system, and here comes that low pressure system that I mentioned. Especially as we get into Thursday, it's going to be more likely that we're going to see some rain showers and maybe a rumble of thunder around here, and then the cooler air will begin to filter in, especially Thursday and Friday. We'll begin to ratchet those temperatures down into the 60s. Here's our GFS model on accumulated rainfall, most of which tallies up Thursday and Friday, anywhere from about a half an inch to an inch there. Again, we're looking for consistency here. As we look at our European model, this one's not quite as bullish on precipitation, anywhere from a quarter to a third, maybe up to about a half an inch in some of those areas, certainly by the end of the week as well. So 76 degrees today. Can't rule out a stray shower or thunderstorm, but a lot of the day will be dry. 78 to almost 80 degrees tomorrow, folks. Maybe a stray shower or thunderstorm. That becomes a bit more likely by the time we get into Thursday with more widespread showers and some scattered thunderstorms there. 68 degrees there. And then it's still a chance of some showers on Friday and Saturday, but cooler temperatures by the time we get into and through our weekend or the beginning of next week. But having said that, those numbers still well above our average or normal high of 54 degrees. That is a look at our forecast. Here's a look at traffic for this Tuesday morning at 6:46.